Some of you might remember that in a previous video, I claimed to have made the fastest video game ever made, with an asterisk. And the asterisk was this. I left the game completely uncapped so that the speed of the game would depend on the skills of you, the audience, with each level being ever faster. And faster and faster. With this act of blame shifting cowardice, I was leaving my reputation in the hands of complete strangers. But viewer, I need not have worried. After a period of frantic record setting, there was one winner, an account called Nicey, who managed to get to level 27 at a speed of over 2,900 meters per second. But as impressive as this is, I wanted more. I wanted to see how fast this baby can go. And so I made an AI. I'm not one of those overconfident wrong answer having machines, or one of those bad finger drawing copyright infringement machines, but a real traditional AI made with the sweat of my own fingertips. Now in a previous life I've worked on AI before, on games like Assassin's Creed 4, the Skate series, and Bully if you remember that one, so it's not my first rodeo. And I found that coding AI is one of the most satisfying things you can work on in games. So join me on a galaxy brain meme fueled journey to discover how fast this thing will go. And also later in the video, how I turned to technology from the 1800s to overcome a significant problem. But before we go on, if you haven't seen the other video where I made the game, go and watch that now and then come back. Go on, I've paused it for you. We'll wait. I'm tired of waiting. Let's kick on.
Level 1. Awakenings.
The first step to creating an AI as a stand-in for the player is to think about how I play the game myself, what my strategies are, what cues I'm looking for, and what techniques I use. And whilst at lower levels I tend to concentrate on skimming close to objects to gain energy quickly, at high levels the game becomes more about pure avoidance, since even if you don't concentrate on skimming you're bound to gain some energy anyway. So that's what the AI will focus on, avoidance. Using a physics sphere cast I could see if there is an obstacle ahead of the ship and how far away that obstacle is. The green tube shows that the AI has detected that the path ahead is clear. When it turns red, this means that the sphere cast has detected an obstacle. So what do we do? Let's start off with a simple approach. When we detect an obstacle, we'll check alternative paths above, below, to the left and the right of the current path. And then we'll just switch to the best of these. Let's see how far the AI can get with this approach. Yeah, definitely not smooth. It kind of looks like someone is playing by tapping on the arrow keys. And there are lots of situations where the four options just don't show a way forwards. Anyway, the AI somehow scraped through to level 4 and then the run ended. Let's keep a scorecard.
Level 2, expansion.
So it's clear that 4 paths just isn't enough. We need more. But sphere-cast checks are expensive and we're already doing up to 5 at once, so how are we going to check more paths whilst keeping the performance high? The answer is to spread the sphere-casts out over several frames. If we do this, then we can check a lot more paths. The cost of this is latency. Every extra frame we use for this delays our decision, but it's a compromise that's worth making. Let's check paths spiraling outwards from the ship in a clockwise direction, reaching ever further outwards. Seems like this should be an improvement. If we slow the footage down, we can see the spiral search in action and how it's spread out over several frames. This increases the chances that the AI will find a good path. Yep, this is much better. The AI didn't collide with anything at all until level 10, and even then it fluked its way into grabbing a shield up just by being in the right place at the right time. Eventually it succumbed to speed at level 13 because it didn't find a path in time. Let's update our table.
Level 3, elevation.
I think we're on a good track here, but we need to improve to beat that high score of 27. One way to do this is by analysing the mistakes that the AI commonly makes. Here we can see that the AI thinks it has identified a clear path, but the problem is that it can't make it here without hitting an obstacle. This is because the AI isn't checking it can reach the new path safely, it just assumes it can. So let's make it check that too. Unfortunately, this means another swept sphere check, but it should be worth it. This is much better. The AI is able to pathfind its way out of tough situations, but even this method has its limits and the AI met its end at level 25, agonizingly close to Nicey's record of 27. Let's update our meme table.
Level 4 Enlightenment.
So I have a theory of why the AI is failing right now. The fact that we have to spread our path search over several frames means that at higher speeds, there just isn't enough time to find the right path. An easy fix for this would be to do more sphere casts per frame, thus finding the path faster, but I don't want to do that because it would affect performance on lower end machines. So let's try to make the search pattern more efficient instead. By changing our spiral pattern so it becomes less dense as we work our way outwards, we can cover more space in less time. Let's see where we're at.
Faster.
Yeah, only slightly better. We've matched Nice's record, but it's still not good enough.
Level 5, Transcendence.
Alright, so we've reached the last stage of the Galaxy Brain meme template, and our AI has only just about matched human ability. So I took a really hard look at what's going wrong when the AI hits an obstacle, and what I found was that most of the time, this was happening. Even though the Pathfinder is successfully finding a new path, and a way to get to the new path, the steering algorithm wasn't doing a good job of staying close to the plan, and sometimes it was still hitting obstacles. So what we need is a better steering algorithm. And for this, I turned to an unexpected source. The steam engine. You see, back in the 1800s, engineers needed an automatic way to control the amount of steam entering into the engine cylinder. So what they invented was the centrifugal governor, a mechanism which automatically controls the steam valves. And in the 1920s, Nicholas Minorsky formalized these kinds of systems as PID controllers, which are great for automatically controlling things using a feedback loop. Anyway, I can already feel your eyes glazing over, so I'll skip the details. But for anyone who wants to solve AI steering in a physics-based simulation, just Google PID controllers. I might have already used these things in a previous game's AI, but I probably shouldn't mention that. Let's see how this thing does. Big, big improvements. The AI breezes past 27 with 3 lives intact and doesn't lose another life until 37, finally tapping out at 39. But before we bring this to a close, I have one more thing to try. So let's bring in a 6th tier. Yes, for the final tier, I asked myself, what would Big Brain Bobby Hill do? And I think what he would do is this. The AI currently ignores shield power-ups completely, so let's make it steer towards them if the path is clear. This works really well. Let's let it run and we'll see where it gets to. Final score of 44 and a speed of 4,560 km/h, dwarfing inferior human attempts and consolidating AI dominance. Now if you remember, I made the game free on the Itch Store, and I've just dropped an update with the new AI code. Hit Shift A to toggle the AI, Shift V to turn on AI visualizations, and Shift C to move the camera so you can see what's going on more easily. So if you want to play around with the AI, or you just want to play the game like a normal human, just go to the link in the description and download it. And I'll see you next time on Indie Dev Lab for more gameplay experiments and tutorials.